Good morning, students. Now, in today's class, we have discussed with that data reduction. So in the data reduction, mainly we have to divide into three types of reductions techniques, strategies, techniques or strategies we have to use in data reduction. First one is the dimensionality reduction. Second one is the numerosity reduction. And the third one is the data compression. So here in the dimensionality reduction, we have to divide into three types: Bayley transforms and principal component analysis, and third one is the attribute subset selection. So these are the concepts we already have to complete in last class. And the second method is the numerosity reduction. In the numerosity reduction, mainly you have to divide into two types of reductions you have to use here. That is, you have to use it in parametric methods, that is the regression, or non-parametric methods. So here, to reduce, whenever you are using the numerosity reduction, to reduce the data of value, choosing various either parametric method or non-parametric method you have to use to reduce the volume of the data. So here you can use the parametric method. That is, generally we have to represent the equation y equal to wx plus b, that you have to represent it as a linear regression form. Here in the regression, the relationship between the two variables or two attributes, you have to represent it this regression. Regression and nonlinear models are useful to approximate the given data. In linear regression, the data are modeled to fit a straight line. The straight line equation is y equal to wx plus b. So later we have to discuss the straight line. In the parametric methods, let us assume the data fits some model, estimate the model parameters, store only the parameters, and then discard the data. So example, for example, we have to take here log linear models, the point in M dimensional space as the product on appropriate marginal subspaces. Another methods, that is the non-parametric methods. Here, do not assume any models here. The major here you can represent it with the histograms, clustering, and sampling methods. See here, first one is the parametric data reduction model or log linear models. First one is generally, you know that the relationship between the two attributes that you have to represent it as regression. So here, two types of regression models you have to use. One is the linear regression and second one is the multiple regression. The relationship between the one variable or attribute. One attribute to another attribute, that is simply called it as linear regression. The relationship between the one attribute and more than one attributes, that means more than attributes that you have to represent it as multiple regression. For example, we have to consider genes of the particular person, depending on his father and mother, his father. So that is the one-to-one relationship you have to represent it. That type of regression is called linear regression. For example, you have to consider a person height depending on his father and his forefathers. That type of relationship you have to call it as multiple regression. So one variable depending on one variable, that is called as linear regression. One variable depending on more than one variable is called as multiple regression. So here you can see data model to fit the straight line, that is in a linear regression. That is the formula you already have to discuss. That is the y equal to wx plus b. That is the y is the constant. We have to represent the constant of data mining with the x and y values. W and p are the regression coefficients. And that is simply called as linear regression and multiple regression. So here you can use the least square method in the linear regression method. And the multiple regression, it allows the response variable y to be modeled as a linear function of multidimensional feature vector. The type of regression is called as multiple regression. It is depending on more than one variable. That is simply you can call it as multiple regression. And the third one is the log linear model. In the log linear model approximates the discrete multidimensional probability distributions. That type of model is called log linear model. So it is completely depending on the discrete values of multidimensional probabilities. So see here how to analyze the regression between the relationship between the variables or attributes. So here you can see regression analysis. What is the regression analysis? A collective name for the techniques for the modeling and analysis of the numerical data consisting of values of a depending variable or dependent variable is also called response variable or measurement. And one or more independent variables, that is simply call it as predictors. The parameters are estimated so as to give best fit of the data. Most commonly best fit evaluated by using least square method. But other criteria has also been used for the prediction, inference, hypothesis testing, and modeling of the causal relationship. See this straight line, that is in regression analysis, that is you are using the least square method. So here you can represent it as, this is the line you have to represent it here. Y equal to x plus 1. This is the straight line. Yeah, this is the straight line you have to represent it as in regression analysis. See here, this is the formula. We can represent the linear regression, multiple regression, non-linear models. So completely, it is the numerosity reduction. In the numerosity reduction, you have to represent it as parasitic methods and non-parasitic methods. These are the parasitic methods. Parasitic methods. And the parametric methods, linear regression, and multiple regressions and log linear models. Linear regression is always completely represents the straight line, that is the y equal to wx plus p. Here you can represent the two big regression coefficients w and b, and specify the line or to be estimated by using the data at hand. So using least square criteria as known values y1 comma y2 and x1 and so on, x1 comma x2 and so on. This is a linear regression. So here one variable or one attribute depending on another attribute. That type of regression is called linear regression. Here you can represent the multiple regression. Many nonlinear functions can be transformed into the above. For example, you can take the condition, linear equation y equal to b naught plus b1 x1 b2 x2. So here one variable depending on more than one depending on more than one variables is called as multiple regression. See in this equation shows that y is depending on x1 and x2. So next one is the log linear models. Approximate discrete multidimensional probability distribution. Estimate the probability of each point in multidimensional space. A set of discretized attributes based on the smaller subset of dimensional combinations. Useful for the dimensionality reduction and data smooth. Here you have to see in a non-parametric methods. Here histogram analysis. So it is non-parametric methods. First one is the histogram analysis. So the entire data you have to divide into buckets and store in average of each bucket. So here you have to partition values, equal width and equal frequency. So for example, you have to consider this data. The range must be equal. For example, we have to consider that is the 0 to 1000, 1000 to 2000, 2000 to 3000, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, 9 to 10 thousands. So that approximate values we have to be presented. So what are the data comes under the between 0 to 1000, 1000 to 2000, like that we have to divide it. Then you have to find the average and average you have to store. Next one is the clustering. Partitioning of data into clusters based on that similarity and store the cluster representation. Can be very effective if the data is clustered, but not if data is smeared. And how the hierarchical clustering can be stored in multidimensional index trees structures. There are many choice of clustering definitions and clustering algorithms you have to use. This is cluster analysis completely depending on what are the data points are grouped in as a cluster. So that you have to discuss it in detail in further classes. So similar sampling. Sampling is also another method you have to use to representing the data. Obtaining a small sample S to represent the whole data set N. Allow a mining algorithm to run in a complexity that potentially sublinear to the size of the data. The key principle of this sampling is, first one is choose a representative subset of the data. Second one, simple random sampling may have very poor performance in the presence of this cube. And the third one is develop and adaptive sampling methods. Stratified sampling, that is simply called as stratified sampling. So, sampling may not reduce the database IOs. So here you have to use the various types of sampling methods you have to use. Simple random sampling, sampling without replacement, sampling with replacement, and stratified sampling. So here, first one, simple random sampling. There is an equal probability of selecting any particular item. Sampling without replacement, once an object is selected, it is removed from the population. Third one, sampling with replacement. Sampling with replacement, a selected object is not removed from the population. Stratified sampling, partition in the data set and draw the samples from each partition. Each partition, approximately the same percentage of the data. It is used to conjunction with the stored data. See here, this is the sampling with replacement and without replacements. Raw data, you have to, by sampling methods, you have to divide the data. Simple random sample without replacement, sample random with replacement. So here you can represent it as, so what are the colors you have in this one? Mainly you have to take the three colors. One is the blue and white and green. So without replacement of those random samples. But whereas here, already you order the data you have. The data you have to replace with the other data. So two blues are you have to consider, but you don't have the here, don't have the two blues. So you have to replace with that data. That type of methods is called with replacements, that is a simple random sample without with replacements. See this cluster and stratified sampling. So raw data first you have to consider. From that raw data you have to take some clusters. A few data points only you have to consider in the stratified sample. Whereas in raw data, you have to represent the all data samples. So data cube aggregation, that is the lowest level of the data cube, basically provide the aggregated data from the individual entity of interest. So example, a customer in a phone calling in a data warehouse. Multiple levels of aggregation in data cubes further reduces the size of the data to deal with. Reference appropriate levels, use the smallest representation, which is enough to solve the task. Queries and regarding aggregated information should be answered using the data cube when possible. So this is the regarding to my data reduction. So last concept in that, in data reduction is data compression. This one is the data reduction. Mainly you have the three types. One is the dimensional reduction. Second one is the numerosity reduction. And third one is the data compression. So just now we have to complete the numerosity reduction. Now you have to discuss with that in numerosity reduction, mainly you have to divide into two types, parametric methods, and second one is the non-parametric methods. So now we have to discuss with that data compression. Here you can represent the data compression. First one is the to compress the data without modification is called as compression. First one is the string compression. There is a extensive theories and well-tuned algorithm. Typically, lossless algorithm, lossy algorithms you have to use here for the compressions. Typically lossless, but only limited manipulation possible without expansion. Audio and video compression, typically lossy compression you have to use here. Whereas in string compression, you have to use the lossless method you have to use. But whereas in audio video compression, you have to use the lossy compression. Lossy compression with a progressive refinement, mainly you have to use. Sometimes small fragments of the signal can be reconstructed without reconstructing the whole. Time sequence is not audio. Typically short and very slowly with time. Dimensionality and numerosity reductions may also be considered as the forms of data compression. See here, this diagram which shows the data compression. So this is the original data. Second one is the original data with approximated data by using the lossy and lossless you have to use. Finally, these all data you have to compress it data. Using a method as a lossless and loss. So that is the last one is the data preprocessing methods or data transformation and data display. So data transformation mainly you have to discuss a function that maps the entire data set of values for a given attribute to the way new set of replacement values. That is simply each old value can be identified with one of the new values. So here, whatever the data you have in the data set, the data you have to fill with that transformation. That means you have to map that value. Methods, what are the methods you have to use here? Here you can use the five methods you have to use in data transformation. Smoothing, that is already you have to discuss removing the noisy data from there. Second one is the attribute and feature construction. New attributes constructed from the given ones. And third one is the aggregation, summarization, data cube construction. And the fourth one is the normalization. Scale to fall with a smaller and a specified range. Min max normalization, z score normalization, normalization by decimal scaling. And the fifth one is discretization, concept hierarchy climbing. This is the last method we have to indicate here. So here in these methods, first two, three methods you have to already you have to covered in so far in last methods. Normalization, here you can use the min-max normalization, z-score normalization, the very important concept in data transformation. And the last one is the discretization method. See here in the normalization method, here all of you, listening my voice. You have any doubts? So if you have any doubts regarding to this one, Please raise your hand and see here, this is the normalization process of min-max normalization technique. So here, by using this formula, you are using the normalized data. For example, here you have to take, by using the min-max normalization technique, this is the actual data. Let income range is $12,000 to $98,000. Now this is the normalized data in between the 0, 0, 0 to 1. So here you have to see, then 73,000 income. You want to map it to normalize. So here we can use the formula B minus minimum amount of the salary and the maximum amount of by divided by maximum salary minus minimum salary. Here we can represent it as we have to normalize to 0 to 1. That time you have to represent the 1 minus 0, that is the new maximum and minus the new minimum. So you can represent the normalize the value 0 to 2. That case, that is the 2 to 2 minus 0. That is the way you have to represent that normalization method. See here, by using this formula, we can normalize the values like this. So let income range is 12,000. That is the 12,000 is the minimum salary. Maximum salary is 98,000. These are values you want to normalize in between the 0 to 1. For example, you have to consider 73,000 salary you want to normalize. So what is the value of the 73,000 you can represent? 73,000 minus 3,600. 73,000 minus 12,000 divided by 98,000 minus 12,000 into normalization value. That is the maximum normalization value. That is the 1 minus 0 plus 0. That is the 0.716. In fact, 73,000 normalization value is you are getting 0.716. That is the way you can normalize the given data using min-max normalization. And the second one is z-score normalization. This is very important. These three normalization techniques are very important. Z-score normalization, mu means mean, and standard deviation, rho. V dash equal to V minus mu A by rho A. So average salary, let us assume 54,000, and its standard deviation value is 16,000. Then you can find out the z-score normalization value. That is the 73,600. So here you have a mistake. It's the 73,600. Okay. 73,600. This is the 73,600. See here, z score normalization v dash equal to v minus mu a rho a. So let us assume the average of the salaries, that is 54,000, and the standard deviation value is 16,000. Now you can find out the z score normalization of a given value, that is the 73,600 minus, that is the average value is 54,000 divided by standard deviation value 16,000. So you get the z score normalization value is 1.225. So this is the way you can find out the z score normalization value. This is the value we have to, after converting the given value, this is the value we have to replace. That is the normalization that are simply can used in transformation. In transformation technique, we have to use the normalization. And third one is the normalization by decimal scaling, v dash equal to v by 10 power j, where j is the smallest integer, which is the maximum. V is less than equal to 1. So this is regarding to that transformation. These are the three techniques mainly we have to use in normalization. And next one is the discretization. This is the last concept here. Here we have the three types of attributes, you know that. One is the nominal attributes, ordinal attributes, and numeric attributes. Nominal values from unordered set, a color, proficient, these are comes under these nominal attributes or nominal values. And second one is the ordinal values. This is the order set, like military rank or academic ranks, we have to represent it as the ordinal values. And the last one is the numerical real numbers, like integers and real numbers, we have to consider this attribute, numeric attributes, ordinal attributes, and nominal attributes. So all the strings are represented with the nominal value, nominal values only. All ordinal values we have to represent with the military ranks or academic ranks. So numeric, integer, and real numbers represent the numeric attributes. So in the discretization method, divide the range of the continuous attributes into intervals. The interval labels can be used to replace the actual data values. Reduce the data size by discretization. Supervised or unsupervised method. Split the up-down and match bottom-up approach. Discretization can be performed recursively on an attribute. Prepare for the further analysis. Data discretization methods. Typical methods mainly you have to use for the data discretization, recursive method, that is the binning, histogram analysis, cluster analysis, distance tree analysis, correlation analysis techniques we have to use. Simple discretization, whenever you are using the binning, equal with the distance partitioning you have to use. First one, you have to divide the range into the n intervals of the equal size, that is the uniform grid. If A and B are the lowest and highest values of the attribute, the width of the intervals will be W equal to B minus A divided by N. The most straightforward outliers may be dominate the presentation. Skewed data is not handled well. So here you can use in the simple discretization in binning method, equal width and equal depth partitioning mainly you have. So see the example, how it works. First, you have to consider these are the values you have to consider. That is the 2, 8, 9, 21, 24, 25, 26, 28, 29, 30. These are the values. All data must be in sorted order. Now, you have to partition into the equal frequency. So totally how many values are there? That is the 12. So here, here you have to take the three bins. That is the each bin has four values. So first four values we have to represent it as in bin one. And next four values you have to represent it as bin two. And the next would be four values we have to represent it as density. 4, 8, 9, 15, 21, 21, 24, 25, 26, 28, 29, 32. Now we can find the mean value. So here you can find out the mean values. 4 plus 8, 12. 12 plus 9, 21. 21 plus 15, 36. 36 by 4, that is the 9. So now the values of smoothing the skin is 9. Okay. Similar way, here also 21 plus 21, 42. 42 plus 6, 24. 66. 66 plus 91. 25, 91. 91 by 5, 4. 23. Okay, that all these are the bins means of for every attribute, that is the 29. Similar way, 26 plus 28 plus 29 plus 34 divided by 4. So we get the 29. So now smoothing this bin means 1 hour we have to find out. Now we have to discuss the bin boundaries. So less than the mean, all you have to represent the minimum value, that is the 4. And the maximum value is the 15. So less than 9, less than or equal to 9, that is all you have to represent it as 4 with the minimum boundaries. And greater than 9, you have to represent it as 15. So see here, in the first one, all are we have to represent it as 4 and except 15. So 15 is greater than 9. So you have to represent it like this. And second bin, 21, 21, 24, 25. So here, the mean is 23. Under 23, we have the two values, that is the 21, 21. Greater than 23. So what is the maximum? Maximum value of in that bin is 23 or is 25. So you have to fill with that remaining values the maximum value, that is the 25. Similar way, third bin, average is 29. So what are the values you have? All we have to fill with the minimum value. Greater than 29, you have to fill with the maximum value, that is the 30. Yeah. So this is the discretization without using the class labels, spinning and what's interesting. See this diagram shows. So this is the discretization by classification and correlation analysis. So the classification mainly you have to represent it here, that is the supervised and correlation analysis. The concept of hierarchy generation. So in the concept of hierarchy generation, mainly organize the concepts hierarchically by the usually associated with each dimension in the data warehouse. Concept of hierarchy facilitate drilling, rolling in data warehouse, view the data in multiple granular. So the concept of hierarchy formation recursively reduce the data by collecting, replacing low level concept by high level concept. Concept hierarchies can be explicitly specified by domain experts and data warehouse designers. Concept hierarchy can be automatically formed for the both numeric and numerical nominal data. For the numeric data and discretization method shown. See here, that is the concept hierarchy generation of the nominal data. Specification of the partial ordering of the attributes explicitly in the schema level by user, by experts. Street, city, state, country. This is the schema level. Specification of the hierarchy for the set of values by explicit data grouping. Alabama, Indiana, Champion, Chicago, that is related to the Illinois. Specification of only partial set of attributes, only street and city, not others. So automatic generation of the hierarchy is by the analysis of the number of distinct values. So here, that is the unrelated data I have represented as in concept hierarchy generation. This is the hierarchy we have to represent: country, provenance of state, city, street, like this. This is the end of the data pre-processing. In the next class, we'll continue the next unit, the third unit. Before discussing about the third unit, how we can implement the data warehouse, once you have to revise, then we'll start the third unit. Okay. These are the, before implementing the data warehouse, you must be pre-processing for that data. That is simply called it as data pre-processing. First one is the data cleaning, data integration, reduction, and transformation and discretization. These are the four methods you have to or you are to call it as task in data pre-processing. Yeah. Thank you. We'll continue in next class.